Hello children, today I will start with the explanation of Act 2, Scene 1. In this scene, a Moroccan prince, that is, a prince of Morocco, comes to present himself as a suitor to Portia. Morocco is a country in Africa. Now, this prince is not only brave and courageous, but he is also very arrogant. He has a false idea of his handsomeness and superiority, and he tells Portia about his bravery and achievements. However, if he chooses the right casket, then only he will be able to marry Portia. Now, this scene is taking place in Belmont, a room in Portia's house. The Prince of Morocco has arrived at Portia's house, and Portia has taken him to a room in her house. Flourish of cornets. Cornets means trumpets. That is, flourish of cornets means the sounding of trumpets is there. Whenever a very important person like a prince or a king used to arrive, then the trumpets were sounded. Now here the prince has come, and so the trumpets were sounded. Enter the Prince of Morocco and his train. Train means his attendants, that is his servants. All the servants also came with him. Portia, Nerissa and other of her attendants. So these are all the people present in this scene. The Prince of Morocco, Portia, Nerissa and the attendants. Morocco, mislike me not for my complexion, the shadowed livery of the burnished sun, to whom I am a neighbor and near bred. Now here the Prince of Morocco was very dark in color. He has a dark complexion. So seeing the beautiful and fair Portia, the Prince of Morocco says that mislike me not, that is, he asks Portia not to dislike him for his dark complexion. The shadowed livery, that is, the dark color of his, is because of the burnished sun. Burnished sun means the burning hot sun, to whom I am a neighbor and near bred. Because Morocco is a place in Africa and it is near the equator, and so it is near the sun also. So that is why it is a very hot place, and people in such hot places are usually dark in color. So he gives the reason for his dark color, that he is coming from a country which is near to the sun. And near bred, that is, he has been brought up in a hot country. Bring me the fairest creature northward born, where Phoebus fire scarce thaws the icicles. Then the Prince of Morocco says that the fairest creature, that is a very white skinned person, should be brought from the north. Northward born means a very fair person who is born in the north should be brought, where Phoebus fire scarce thaws the icicles. And this north, in the extreme north, that is in the north pole, the Phoebus fire, that is, Phoebus is the sun god. And fire here means heat. So in the extreme north of the earth, that is in the north pole, the sun's heat scarce thaws, that is, it hardly melts the ice. That means the extreme north of the earth is a very cold place. And let us make incision for your love, to prove whose blood is reddest, his or mine. And then what does the Prince of Morocco say? That a fair creature, a fair person from the north should be brought. And he belonged to a very hot place. And this fair person, he belonged to a very cold place. And then an incision should be made. Incision means then a cut should be made in their skin, to prove whose blood is reddest, his or mine. Because it was believed that a very brave person's blood was the reddest. I tell thee, lady, this aspect of mine hath feared the valiant. And then the Prince of Morocco says that this aspect means appearance, that is, his dark appearance hath feared the valiant, has feared means frightened even the valiant, even the bravest men. That is, even the bravest men used to be frightened of his dark color, dark appearance. By my love, I swear, the best regarded virgins of our clime have loved it too. But he says that the best regarded virgins, that is, best regarded means the most respected virgins, means unmarried girls of our clime, that is, of his climate, that is, his country, loved that color. So here he is trying to say that the bravest men, he was so brave and courageous that even the bravest men were afraid of his dark color, but the most respected virgins loved that dark color. I would not change this hue, and he is so proud of his color that he says that he would not change this hue. Hue means color, his dark color, except to steal your thoughts, my gentle queen. So he says that he is not ready to change his dark color except to steal your thoughts, means except to win the favor of Portia. Portia, in terms of choice, I am not solely led by nice direction of a maiden's eyes. Now here Portia says that in terms of choice means as regards the conditions of choice, that is the choice that was given to her, I am not solely led. Solely led means entirely influenced by nice direction of a maiden's eyes. Nice direction means by the attractive looks which pleases a maiden's eyes. Maiden means a young girl's eyes. That is, she did not have the choice to be influenced by the good looks of any other person. Besides, the lottery of my destiny bars me the right of voluntary choosing. And besides, her choice, the lottery of my destiny, that is the lottery system which had been designed by her father for her destiny, for her, which was to decide her fate, bars me the right. Bars me means stops her, prevented her the right of voluntary choosing. Right of voluntary choosing means prevented her from giving the freedom to choose what she wanted. That is, she did not have the freedom to choose her own husband. But if my father had not scanted me and hedged me by his wit to yield myself his wife, who wins me by what means? That means I told you. And here she says that if my father had not scanted means restricted. If by that lottery system, her father had not restricted her and hedged me. Hedged means bound. Bound her by his wit. Wit means wisdom. That is the lottery system according to which he had to marry the person who chose the right casket. That was the wit of her father, wit shown by her father for her marriage. To yield myself his wife who wins me. And according to that lottery system, she had to yield herself. Yield means to, she had to give herself as the wife of the person who wins me by that means I told you. That is, the person who chooses the right casket, he will have Portia as his wife. Yourself, renowned prince, then stood as fair as any comer I have looked on yet for my affection. And then Portia turns to the Prince of Morocco and says that you yourself then stood as fair as any comer. That is, he also stood as good as any comer. Comer means suitor, as any other suitor. I have looked on, yet he that she had seen so far, and to give her affection. So here she, Portia is trying to say that she doesn't make any difference between the Prince of Morocco and other suitors on the basis of skin color. Morocco, even for that I thank you. So when Portia says that she is ready to marry the person who chooses the right casket, even if it is the Prince of Morocco, then it makes him happy and he thanks Portia for saying such a thing. Therefore, I pray you lead me to the caskets to try my fortune. And then he tells Portia to take him to the caskets so that he can try his fortune. That is, he can try his luck. By the scimitar that slew the Sophie and the Persian, and a Persian prince that won 3 fields of Sultan Solomon. Now here the Prince of Morocco, he gives examples as to what he had done to prove his how brave and courageous he is. So he takes out his scimitar. Scimitar means a small sword, and he says that with that sword he slew the Sophie. Slew means killed, and Sophie means the emperor of Persia. So with that sword he had killed the emperor of Persia and a Persian prince, and he has also killed a Persian prince that won 3 fields, that is 3 battles against Sultan Solomon, that is the Sultan of Turkey, Suleiman. I would outstay the sternest eyes that look. And then the prince says that he is ready to outstay. Outstay means he is ready to defy the sternest eyes that look. That is, he is ready to look into the most frightening eyes. He is not afraid of the sternest eyes. Outbrave the heart most daring on the earth. And he is also ready to outbrave, that is, defy the heart most daring, that is, the bravest person on the earth. That is, he is ready to challenge even the bravest person on earth. Pluck the young sucking cubs from the she-bear. Then he also says that he can pluck. Pluck means snatch, forcefully take away the young sucking cubs from the she-bear. And this is a very dangerous thing. It is not very easy to take away the babies from a mother bear, but he is ready to do that also. Yea, mock the lion when he roars for prey. And he says that he can also mock the lion. Mock the lion means challenge the lion when it is roaring for prey. Roaring for prey means when it is hungry and searching for prey. So that is also a very dangerous thing, particularly when a lion is hungry, it is very dangerous to go near it. To win the lady. But why is the Prince of Morocco ready to do all this? Just to win, that is, just to win over the beautiful Portia. But alas, the while. Now here the Prince of Morocco sighs, because he sees that there is something that is there which is not in his hands. And he realizes that even though he is brave and powerful, there is something that can defeat him. If Hercules and Lichas play at dice, which is the better man, the greater throw may turn by fortune from the weaker hand. And here, to prove that he also can be defeated, he gives the example of Hercules and Lichas. And in the Greek mythology, Hercules is a very powerful man and Lichas was his servant. So here the master, that is Hercules, and the servant Lichas was playing a game of dice. Which is the better man, in order to decide who was the better man. The greater throw may turn by fortune from the weaker hand. And what happens when the master and servant are playing? The greater throw, that is the winning throw, may turn by fortune, may be made by luck from the weaker hand, that is by the servant. So in this way, what happens? So is Alcides beaten by his page. And in this way, Alcides is another name for Hercules. So in this way, Hercules can be beaten. Beaten means defeated by his page. Page means servant. So in this way, even if Hercules was so powerful, he can be defeated by his own servant. So it all depends upon luck. And so may I, blind fortune leading me. So here, Prince of Morocco says, so in the same way, just as Hercules can be defeated by his servant, in the same way, he can also be defeated by blind fortune. Fortune is said to be blind because we see that the goddess of fortune is blindfolded. The eyes of the goddess is covered, tied up with a piece of cloth. Why? Because fortune does not see differences. It judges equally. It does not see whether a person is powerful or weak, whether a person is rich or poor. It judges equally. So the Prince of Morocco says that blind fortune, that is, he has a blind chance of winning, that is, choosing the right casket. Miss that which one unworthier may attain. Miss that means maybe he will lose the contest, that is, he can choose the wrong casket. Which one unworthier, which can be chosen. By an unworthier means a less worthy person than him. So the right casket can be chosen by an unworthier person than the Prince of Morocco, and die with grieving. And when he loses, when he doesn't choose the right casket, then what will happen? He will have to die with grieving, that is, with sorrow. Portia. You must take your chance and either not attempt to choose at all. So Portia here, in a way, she's trying to give a warning to the Prince of Morocco. Just as she disliked the previous suitors, here she doesn't like the Prince of Morocco also. So she gives him, in a way, a warning that you have to take your chance. You have to try. Either not attempt to choose at all, or you should not attempt to choose at all. Either you take your chance or you just don't choose the casket. Or swear before you choose, if you choose wrong, never to speak to lady afterward in way of marriage. And here Portia tells the same condition to the Prince of Morocco also, which made the other suitors also go away without choosing the casket. So what does she say, tell the Prince of Morocco? That he will have to swear before he chooses that if he chooses the wrong casket, then never to speak to lady afterward. Then he will never speak to any lady afterward in way of marriage, that is, on the subject of marriage. So if he chooses the wrong casket, then the Prince of Morocco will not ask any other lady to marry him. So this condition is laid down by Portia before the Prince of Morocco. Therefore be advised, therefore think carefully. Morocco, nor will not. But here Morocco, what does he say? No, nor will not. That is, he will definitely not. Come, bring me unto my chance. So Portia thought that maybe he will be discouraged and he will go back without choosing the casket. But here Morocco says that if he chooses the wrong casket, he will not ask any other lady to marry him. So bring me unto my chance. Allow him to make the choice. Portia, first forward to the temple. After dinner, your hazard shall be made. So Portia tells Morocco, when Portia says that Morocco is ready to choose the casket, she tells him that first they will go to the temple where he will have to take the oath. And then after dinner, your hazard means your risky choice shall be made. You will choose the casket. Morocco, good fortune then, good luck then. So he wishes himself good luck. To make me blessed or cursed among men. And then he knows that it depends upon fortune to make him either blessed or cursed among men. That is the choice will make him blessed or cursed. If he chooses the right casket, he will be a very happy man. And if he chooses the wrong casket, he will be very sad and disappointed. Cornets, that is the sounding of trumpets, and exeunt. Exeunt means they go. Now, this is the end of Act 2, Scene 1. Just to revise this, it is a small, short scene. Revise this and note down all the meanings and important points.